Let's create our first comic. As you can see here, I have two pages for a very simple comic. Let's name it comic. And inform the type as comic. As you can see here, comics are recommended for simple projects with simple interaction. Comics are also more interesting to see in big screen size. That's why you're not seeing here the iPhone or Android phones. But as you can see, if you decide to create as an iPad, you will be able to see it also in iPhone 4. The orientation also, it's mandatory one for portrait mode because it's a comic. And because we have a document open here, Kwik asks us if you want to use it or not. So let's create. We could do the same for the second page. Just come in here and click Add New Page. Again, we'll be asked to use the open document as reference. And also you can name the page. Let's accept the default one. You can go to the first page, just double-click in it. Now let's add some interactive here. You can quickly create a camera here. And the camera is just a way to tell the comic to zoom the area that you want. So let's say we want to zoom this part of our document here. As you can see, a camera was created. Let's add another one. And let's say we want this camera here, covering this full area. With that, we are ready to go. But sometimes you want to disable or to hide some cameras. You can do that quickly using the Show Hide Cameras button. Let's preview it. Every time you preview a new project, you are going to see this alert. It's pretty much telling you that although all images were exported, you still need to create your own default icons if you decide to publish it in App Store or the Android Marketplace. Now that Corona opens, you can preview your project. It's under Documents, Kwik, your project name, in our case Comic, Folder Build. Let's select our device as iPad and open it. Every time that you flip the page, you see the zoom areas you just created.